Hey everybody, welcome back. Today I'm going to take on a project that is unfortunately something I have to deal with. I'm going to be working on a 1981 Yamaha XJ650's whole front end. I'll show you here. So this is my beautiful little rat rod of a motorcycle here. Got it for $100 from a guy and have rode it for about 3 years, and then you start to see this problem right here. Last fall, a lady slammed on her brakes in front of me. I pulled my controls as fast as I could, but I still ran into her bumper, and so my forks went under her bumper and bent back. What I'm going to be tackling is right here, the lower triple tree part is kinked a little bit, because when you follow this line up, it doesn't fit into there. So as I'm rolling out my forks, I see that problem. It's going to be a bit of a project. I'm going to start out by pulling out these bolts here. I want to get these handlebars rolled back. I already got the tire and axle off and everything there. I want to roll my handlebars back, and then I'm going to have to take this large cap nut off, and then see what it takes to pull the entire triple tree center out. That's hard to see, but this whole unit needs to come down and out. And then I can see how my bearings are doing, and I'll put a new lower triple tree piece in that's not bent, so that I have a straight line from here to here, and then I can put a new set of forks in. All right, so I got these bolts loosened up, and these come off pretty easy. So the next thing I'm gonna do is loosen this, that Allen bolt right there, and then we'll take this cap off here, and then I got to get these 10 millimeters off. This entire headlight and gauge assembly needs to come off in order for me to get this triple tree out of here. So the last bolt that holds that headlight on is down here, and once I remove those three bolts, I believe this whole assembly should come forward. I'm gonna have to see how the electrical is gonna hang, or if I'm going to start digging into the headlight assembly and unplugging stuff to let it get out of the way. But here we go. We're making some good headway here. The next bolts that need to come out are these 10 millimeters right here, so that we can get this ignition pulled away. And then the other thing that is key to point out is that right here we've got a tachometer cable, and over here we've got the speedometer cable. Those are just collars that spin off. They look like this. And so you just spin them off with your finger, hopefully. I mean, I guess a guy could use a pliers on those, but you want to try to just use your fingers so you don't gnarl those up and make them all gross. All right, gonna keep working on it. All right, let's take this cap nut off. Need yourself a 22 millimeter socket, and let it come and rest on the stop right here, and then that lets you crack this loose. Okay, my bad. This is a bolt, and comes off like that. And then once that's off, and because we took that bolt out, this comes right up. We're gonna start seeing what we gotta do to crack this loose. Okay, had to dig around a little bit to find this tool, but this is a spanner wrench. You can see how it has an arc in it, and it's got this prong that sticks out and grabs into this nut with the slots in it. What I had to do, because the radius on that arc is a little too big, is I stick a tip of a screwdriver that's got a multiple bit insert in there, because it gives me the proper stand back or standoff to grip into that slot really good. I don't want to round that out. Okay, so now that you have that nut loose, take your time, because we got a bunch of ball bearings down here, and we've got, you just heard one tink. You got a bunch up here. So sometimes they stick in the grease, but when it's dry and crusty like this, you got to really be cautious and take your time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my magnet here and try to collect all these before they go flying down and into who knows where land. And voila, there we go, all my ball bearings. Besides the one that ran away, but we'll find that in a minute. Everything came apart real nice. I took the time to clean this out really good with a rag. Maybe I'll even get a little farther in there to get that grease out of the edge there. But I wanted to make sure I got the bearing, or the bearing set, real clean. And then you come up here and got this one all nice and cleaned up too. So everything looks good. I'm going to slide the new triple tree that's not bent up and in. Grease the bearings, try to set them in one at a time. Be careful not to lose them. And see if we have success here in the next few minutes of getting this triple tree bolted back on. All right, I'll show you a little trick here that I think helps keep my grease nice. I put a little paintbrush in there. And that way when I come up here and need to put grease on things, I just use this little brush and put the grease wherever I want it. And then when I'm done, put the brush back in the can, throw the lid back on it, and everything stays pretty nice and clean. All right, so something that I do to be able to get a hold of these little ball bearings is I actually put a little grease on my brush and then just stick it right in there. It's a lot easier than trying to pick up a greased pig. They just stick right on the brush, and then if there's enough grease on there, then they just fall right into place around the grease of the bearing there. Takes 18 ball bearings to completely fill the gaps around there. I've got them nicely gooped in there. And I'm also fighting Murphy's Law of what can go wrong, will go wrong, by having a tub under here. That way, if any of those had fallen out, I'm working in some sort of a way to catch it, which happened a few times. And that way also, when I slide it up here into my steering tube, if any of those do fall out, well, they're just going to be caught right here in the tub. All right, so this piece slides in real easy. There's no like pressure or anything like that. But one thing I would say is because these ball bearings will fall out if they're not pressed up into the steering tube, I just grabbed a little 5-in-1 to wedge it up, because now I need to come up here, grease this really good, set my ball bearings in up here before I can put my cap nut on. All right, got the top ball bearings in here. And again, to make sure that I don't have anything run away, I kept a rag wrapped around here. And I also did the process of keeping this real goopy. And then this brush being goopy worked as a little sticky finger to help put those in there. And we are successfully now about ready to put the cap nut on. With tightening these spanner nuts, the way you want to do it is you tighten them until you start to feel just a little bit of resistance in the bearing, the ball bearings, because they're not quite flowing smoothly. Then you back this off just a little bit. So that's when you know you've come to the max out of your tightness, and then you give it just a little bit of relief, and then you bring this nut down nice and tight to lock against the other spanner nut.